acknowledging them as a nuclear weapons state, or by being willing to have discussions, by being willing to give them concessions. There are people in the United States that feel that any assistance, any aid that's been given North Korea has only gone to further strengthen this country's development of their nuclear arsenal. But then there's another viewpoint that at this point they've come so far with developing these weapons that if the world continues its strategy that has proven to be a failure, and in fact Russian President Vladimir Putin just a couple of days ago said that he believes putting pressure on North Korea, fiery rhetoric, sanctions, he believes it's a dead-end road and is only going to make the situation more dangerous. Because what North Korea has shown the world is that despite round after round, and round 7 of UN Security Council sanctions was just passed, despite all of that, despite attempts to cut them off, they have found ways to get around the sanctions, to continue bringing in money through any means necessary and possible, and they have continued to advance more quickly than most analysts believed that they would, even as recently as just a few years ago. And so now you have yet another apparent nuclear test at the Punggye-ri nuclear test site, creating an explosion so powerful that it could be felt as an earthquake across the border in China. And you have North Korea defiantly saying that they're not worried about what China is going to do. They're not worried about what the United States is going to do, or Japan or South Korea. They are going to do what they see as necessary to protect their national sovereignty, and more importantly, for them to continue to have leverage over the rest of the world. And they essentially have created a scenario, Aisha, where even though the United States is far more wealthy and far more powerful, North Korea has something that the United States is going to be very hard-pressed to find a response to, because all military analysts would say that a preemptive strike, a military option against a nuclear North Korea, would be far too dangerous for the country to accept. I mean, the humanitarian consequences would be catastrophic. So what option does that leave the United States? The United States needs to talk with North Korea. And there's a lot of people in Washington that don't like the sound of that, that don't like to reward a country for bad behavior, for illegal behavior. But if they don't do that, there are others who say this is going to continue to escalate and become increasingly more dangerous, because obviously North Korea is not stopping their nuclear development.
That's right. Will Ripley joining us there on the line with some great insight. Will there in Tokyo, we appreciate it. Do stand by for us. We will, of course, be coming back.